Hi friends, how are you all? How's studies going on? I hope all well. Boss, now is a high time to study, right? Okay, so now what are we going to do? We are going to start the new chapter today. Goods lost or destroyed or pilfered. Basically, this chapter is what? This chapter is basically a protection to the importer. This chapter is actually going to protect the importer. In what terms? Simply, see, if I am an importer and I have imported some goods, but the goods are not received only, they got pilferaged, theft, or the goods are destroyed before reaching in my hands, or goods are damaged, goods are destroyed, goods are damaged, goods are deteriorated, goods are theft. So why will I pay duty on those goods? Why I won't pay duty on those goods? And make sense? See, I have ordered the goods, I have imported the goods, I have got the goods, I have received the goods, surely I'll pay the duty. I have no doubt in that. But if I've not received the goods only, then why will I pay duty? And make sense? Logical? Nothing wrong in that? Exactly. This chapter is basically going to teach us protection to the importers. When are you going to protect the importers? So in this chapter, we will be studying few sections. In this chapter, we will be studying few section. Section 13, section 21, 22, 23 and 24. We are going to study 5 sections in this chapter. Section 13, section 21, 22, 23 and 24. And honestly, one of the important chapter in the exam. One of the important chapter in the exam. Now next thing, this sections you have to you have to be crystal clear. When is this section going to be applicable? Because you will get, importer will get benefit only when the section applies. And this section will apply only in a given time period. Am I clear? So you have to be crystal clear with the words, with the time period. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Okay, so now let's start with the first section. Goods, duty of pilfered goods. Duty of pilfered goods. Are you open with me? Duty of pilferage. What do you mean by pilferage? What do you mean by pilferage? Pilferage means what? Pilferage is theft. Pilferage is theft. The term pilfer is defined to mean loss of goods in small quantities, by reason of theft. Therefore, the term does not include loss of total package. Boss, it is just a theft. Just small quantity. Suppose I had 500 units, 10 units are not there. Theft is there. Then section 13 will be applicable. But if it's a loss of total package, then section 13 will not be applicable. Am I clear? Now understand. When is section 13 applicable? Scenario is important because this section will be applicable only in this given time period. If something happens in this given time, something means if pilferage happened in this given time period, only then you will get the benefit of section 13. Okay, first, if any imported goods are pilfered after unloading, see, we've already studied the import procedure. You already studied the import procedure. What have you studied? The person in charge brings the goods. Person in charge brings the good and he does the unloading. Am I clear? He does the unloading. I hope you're with me. With the custodian. Who has the goods? Now the goods are with the custodian. In the custody of the custodian. Am I clear? After unloading. But before the proper officer has made an order for clearance of goods for home consumption or deposit in the warehouse. I hope you remember. After, see what happened. Once the goods are unloaded, the goods are in the hands of custodian. Then importer will come. Importer will come and submit bill of entry. And either he will submit bill of entry for home consumption or he will submit bill of entry for warehousing. And once I submit bill of entry and after everything goes well, then proper officer will give an order that now you can clear the goods for home consumption or you can clear the goods for warehousing. So before order, after unloading, and before order, order, the word what they have used is order. After unloading, and if before order, please, time period is very important, then only section 13 will be applicable. Section 13 says that if goods are unloaded, and now the goods are with the custodian. So after unloading and before order by proper officer for home consumption or deposit in the warehouse, the goods got pilferage in this period before order. Before an order, you be with me. Before an order, the goods got pilferage. Then in that case, the importer shall not be liable to pay duty levable on such good, except where such goods are restored to the importer after pilferage. Normally, if in this period the goods got pilferage, the importer will not be liable to pay duty, provided the pilferage goods are restored. You have received, you got the goods back, and then if you have given it to the importer, then the importer will have to pay the duty. Am I clear? If goods are pilfered after order of clearance is made, order is issued that you can take the goods for home consumption or you can take the goods for warehousing. If goods are pilfered, that means while giving order, everything was good. While giving the order, everything was good. Nothing was wrong. No pilferage. Exact quantity was there. Now, after order, but before the goods are actually cleared, if goods are pilferage after the order of clearance is made, but before the goods are actually cleared, duty is levable, because section 13 is not applicable. Section 13 will be applicable when goods are unloaded, but order is yet not given by the proper officer. In between this period, what happens? If goods are pilferage, then importer will get the benefit of the section and importer will have not to pay the duty on this goods. I hope you're getting my point. Am I clear till here? Am I clear? Please, again I'm specifying, just read the time period. Then we know the meaning of the term pilferage. Pilferage means what? Small quantity of theft. Am I clear? Now the question comes. Okay, importer is not liable to pay duty as per section 13. Agreed or not? Why will I pay duty? Because I am importer but I have not received the goods. Why will I pay the duty on those goods? Agreed or not? Am I clear? But now question comes. Who will pay the duty? Tell me. In whose custody the goods were there at the time of pilferage? Custodian. Liability of duty in case of pilfered goods. It is important to note that Port Trust Authority is a custodian of the imported goods. Section 13 disables the government from collecting the duty on pilfered goods from importer. Government will not collect, department will not collect the duty from the importer under Section 13. Am I clear? Section 13 disables the government from collecting the duty on pilfered goods from the importer. On the other hand, Section 45 of the custom provides that if any imported goods are pilfered after unloading thereof in a custom area while in the custody of a person approved by principal commissioner or commissioner under section 45 subsection 1, then such custodian of cargo shall be liable to pay duty on such goods. First listen till here. Boss, who is liable to pay duty in this scenario? As per section, I hope you're with me, as per section 45 subsection 1, the person was approved by principal commissioner or commissioner. That means who is an approved custodian. An approved custodian is liable to pay the duty on such goods. Am I clear? Now question comes, ma'am, at what rate will he have to pay the duty? See, normally when you properly import the goods, you have the rates. But here I the problem is I don't know when the goods got pilferage. Am I clear? Then what rate? At the rate prevailing on the date of delivery of import manifest or import report to the proper officer under section 30 of the convention. The day person in charge give first import manifest. I hope you remember the import procedure we have studied in depth. Am I clear? The day the person in charge submit the import manifest in case of air and water and import report in case of land, that day's prevailing rate. On that rate, the customer will have to pay the import duty. Am I very clear? Am I very clear? Can I go in? Section 13 and section 45 are independent section. I hope you're with me. Am I clear? Am I clear? In other words, whether duty is paid or payable by the customer or not, remission cannot be denied to the importer by the department. Boss, what are you saying? You don't know whether customer is going to pay the duty or not. I don't know. He may not. But assume customer is not paying the duty by XYZ reason. That does not mean that importer will have to pay the duty. No. Importer has been given the benefit under section 13 that he will not be paying duty in case of pilferage when after unloading and before the order by proper officer for home consumption or for warehousing. Am I clear? Am I clear till you? Any problem till you? Any problem? Can I go at? Is section 13 clear? Section 13 clear. I'm revising it again. First, what is section 13? Section 13 talks about pilferage. When? After unloading, but before order by proper officer for home consumption or warehousing. In between, if goods are pilfered, then importer will not be liable to pay duty on such goods. Then this is said by section 13. Then the question comes, who will pay the duty? Section 45 states that approved custodian means the one who is approved by principal commissioner or commissioner, he will be liable to pay duty on such goods. At what rate? At the rate prevailing on the day person in charge has submitted what import manifest or import report. Am I clear? Yes. Section 13 very clear. Any problem till here? Can I go to the next section? Okay.